Welcome, my friends, to CES 2026. Let's see what we can find.
Except there's a problem, a big one. It is lurking behind every demo, every product launch, every powered by AI sign on the show floor. It is about to affect a lot of the technology you're seeing here.
AI is, of course, one of the big talking points here at CES, for good and for bad. A lot of the stuff you see here is powered by AI in one way or another. As you can see, these giant servers, though, don't come without a cost. So for the last few months, we've been talking quite a lot about the RAM crisis. And it's sort of like the undertone of the show. A lot of the companies I've been speaking with are quite concerned. They're concerned about having to raise prices, which obviously no one wants to do. The problems are essentially baked at this point. There's no putting the genie back in the bottle. Really, it's just a matter of trying to manage and see which companies have the best supply chains. And especially when it comes to some of the stuff that's coming out here at the show, a lot of these items are, I'll be honest with you, probably going to be a little bit out of reach for most people. It almost has a little bit of a different tone this year, where a lot of the really cool stuff is like, oh, that's awesome. And yeah, maybe it will be out in a year or two at $200 more than it would have been.
I mean, this is just the reality now. Prices are going up and availability is going down. But that doesn't mean that everything is depressing. There are categories where companies are solving real problems with legitimately clever engineering.
One of the things that you'll see a lot at CES this year are robots. And this is the ping pong robot from Sharpa. Robots have become incredibly popular. Matt was just chasing a little baby robot.
Baby robot was chasing me.
You know, robots have been at CES forever. But I think the thing that's impressing me is that it feels like this year, robots have kind of like taken a pretty big step forward, because it's not like a couple of random things here and there. They're everywhere. They're going viral from like escaping the booths and walking out of the convention center. Like, that's pretty cool. Are you ready to go home yet?
Yeah. I'm seeing a lot of robots. They're not the robots we used to see, where they're like vacuum cleaners. These are legitimate robots that we all imagined when we were younger.
And there's a robot vacuum cleaner sponsoring this video.
24.
That's great.
I want to give a huge shout out to Roborock for sponsoring our CES coverage.
Roborock has one of the coolest booths at CES this year, and some of the engineering that has gone into these robot vacuums is legitimately next level. This is the Saros 20, and it has a system called Adaptive Lift that allows it to climb over double thresholds that would stop most robot vacuum cleaners, like 4 centimeters. It's also incredibly slim and only 8 centimeters tall, so it can actually fit underneath your couch. And Roborock also showed a very cool vacuum that can climb actual stairs. It has a wheel on a leg, and it just goes up. And I did not think we were at this point with robot vacuum cleaners, but here we are. And then there's the Curve 2 Flow, which is all about mopping. The clever part is that it automatically covers the mop when it hits carpet so you don't get your carpet wet, and that pulls the cover back automatically when it needs to mop again on the hard floor. Super smart engineering that solves an actual problem. This is what a soccer game set up, where if you could kick the ball through these tiny gates, you'd win a prize.
Oh, I get two shots?
Get two shots.
Easy. Oh, ho, ho, ho. That's bad. That's bad. No, I couldn't even get to the first one.
Goldfish don't climb trees.
Thank you very much, my friend. I appreciate it.
Kind of embarrassing. But huge thanks again to Roborock for sponsoring our CES coverage. If you want to check out anything I talked about, I'll of course have links in the description of this video. And look, that's the thing about CES this year, because there are real challenges, but there's also genuinely impressive innovation going on as well.
Have you found anything that's remotely good?
No.
Cool, that sounds like about right. Well, we're just gonna put this off the side because this is the brand new Legion Rollable Concept Laptop. So while it looks like a normal 16-inch laptop at first, if you push function and write, it just becomes a 22-inch device. And then if that's not enough, you can push it again. And then it becomes a 24-inch 24x9 gaming display. Hell yeah, brother, would be the first thing I say. So this is a concept. There's some things that are not fully worked out yet. So what they've actually got are a series of sensors around where the webcam is. It's not working on this demo unit yet, but you should be able to swipe to open the screen. You also could use like a hand gesture. Now it's a little thicker than a normal laptop display for sure, but it's actually really impressive engineering. And while yes, if you look really close in the light, you can see a little bit of a crinkle. Unless you actually have like a real like bit of glare on it to see, it's not that noticeable. They could probably pull this off if they want, but the question is, would you actually buy it? I've been told on good authority that the Legion team are checking the comments of this video. So they said that if you want this thing, let them know.
And speaking of displays, this is the first year I've walked CES and genuinely thought we might be at the end game of display tech. I mean, these massive bright 130-inch micro LEDs, wallpaper OLEDs that are so thin, and transparent displays that actually look incredibly impressive.
They've always looked good, but the size, the scale, the brightness, you can't tell in a video, right? There's no way you're gonna be able to tell watching on your phone, on your TV or whatever. I guess we just need lots of money now. I am here at the world famous Las Vegas Sphere, although gotta be honest, I did kind of think it was gonna be a little bit bigger. So I'm here at ASUS, and one of the things that jumped out to me is this, the brand new RG Strix 5K XG27. What makes this unique, this is one of the first not only 5K gaming monitors I've seen, but it's a 5K 180Hz display that you can flip over to QHD at 330Hz. Definitely a little bit more of a niche kind of thing, but the fact that you can get a 5K monitor that is going to be good enough for you to do creative work while also flipping over into gaming mode and still getting QHD at 330Hz, this is legitimately really cool. I'm here with my very good friend, Snazzy Labs. Quinn, how are you?
Hi, Austin. I'm doing very well.
What do you think about CES this year?
Well, I've been here for all of about 7 minutes.
What are you hoping to find at CES?
Well, I found you.
Can I have uppies next?
Yeah.
If you've ever built a gaming PC with an all-in-one liquid cooler, you'll know that it is not a super fun thing to do. However, ASUS actually have a really clever idea here. So it is their new Q connector. So this is a cooler that you can just pop the actual screen off. So this is magnetic, and you see that there's a series of pogo pins for that. But on top of that, this entire setup is attached with only the 4 screws you need to mount. When you screw the cooler on, it also connects to those pogo pins, meaning that when you're ready to install your AIO, there's nothing else you need to do. There's not a single wire you need to run. It is about as idiot-proof as it gets.
And then there's this, NVIDIA's DLSS 4.5. It might be one of the most practically impressive things at the show. Now I know, upscaling doesn't sound exciting. We're getting to the point where I genuinely kind of can't tell native resolution from AI upscaling.
Like, they've done such a good job of clearing up things like ghosting. You've got actually quite a lot of detail, even I'm looking down at like these tiny little like sort of trees and branches and stuff. They've also got the new frame gen. So previously DLSS would go up to 4x. Now you can go all the way up to 6x. On top of that, they also have an automatic mode. So it will actually try to target the frame rate of your monitor. It is actually getting to the point where I struggle to see downsides to turning a lot of it on, especially when it comes to the latency, when it comes to the image quality. And actually, it's the sort of same thing when it comes to GeForce Now.
And with GPU prices climbing because of the component shortage, you can get high-end performance without needing high-end hardware. That actually kind of matters.
A lot of this tech that has been good is now getting to the point where if you hit some of these like logos and like signs they had up, I don't think I could tell you that this is not running natively. This stuff's getting good, man. This stuff is getting really good.
As a lot of you probably know, I am a big fan of cars. I absolutely love them. And here at CES, I think I found the absolute coolest car in the entire show floor. It's over here. So maybe you've seen a video I did last year taking a look at the Afila 1. Now, while that video was sponsored, this is not. And I will say that I am legitimately a huge fan of the car. I have pre-ordered one. I'm waiting for one to show up at some point this year. But not only do they have a bunch more information about the Afila 1, they also have a brand new concept. So this is an SUV that's sort of based on that same sort of like Afila 1 look. But the main thing is that the Afila 1, it's shipping soon. And they've got a lot more details about it. The car basically has ChatGPT built in. Because of course it does. At this point, I'm pretty sure my next toaster is going to have an AI assistant. Beyond just the pure tech element of things, there's actually just like cool ideas and concepts, right? You've got a display on the front. You've got yourself all kind of screens on the inside. It's very customizable. You can play PlayStation games inside your actual car. Like, there's a lot of really cool stuff here. My understanding is this is actually one of the first cars off the actual real production line. So with any luck, I will be behind the wheel of an Afila later this year. Maybe not that one, definitely this one.
It is not CES without my yearly tradition. So excited. I hope he remembers me. I'm gonna be really sad if he doesn't remember me. Dr. Boss. He's always Dr. Fuji to me. Dr. Fuji,
hey,
how's it going?
Hey, how's it going? God. Oh my God, I'm Dr. Boss. Change your name.
This is 2026 CES. The mission is innovation show up. Digital health and AI lifestyle here.
You got AI now?
Oh yes, living longer, longevity. This is Dr. Fuji, change your name. Dr. Boss, big.
Try this one?
Oh yeah.
Okay. Oh, so good. All right, this is the real Dr. Boss experience. Oh, we're going up now. Oh, yeah. Oh, my legs are kicking.
This is have a knee range of motion. That chair is a medical benefit for your knee injury person after sports. We love you, yeah, Dr. Boss. Yeah, we love you so much. You saw the video. We have websites, www.thefuji.com.
With that, my friends, that's all for CES 2026. Thank you very much for watching. Make sure to subscribe to the channel.
We love you, my God. I love you.
I'll be here the rest of the day. Goodbye.